WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
It has been another hot one, so hot some temperatures hit record highs today. Good evening, I'm Nigel Robertson in for Michael.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. News 4 Chief Meteorologist John Sesrich has the latest. John, how hot did it get?
Well, I'll tell you, Carol and Nigel, I guess it depends on where you live, but either way you slice it, at the GSP International Airport, it was a record high today. That's been this, by the way, this old record's been around for a long time. Officially at the GSP International Airport, we reached 100 degrees this afternoon. The old record on this date, 98 degrees, set back in 1888. It's been around for a long time. How about the heat outside right now? We've only dropped a degree officially at GSP. It's 99 right now in Spartanburg, 99 in Greenville, 91 in Asheville. The record high at in the mountains, 94 degrees. Officially, we hit 92, so we didn't break a record in the mountains. But look how hot it is right now. These are the actual temperatures. It's not the heat index. 102 currently in Clemson, 100 in Anderson, 100 also in Greenwood and in Columbia. It's currently 99 in Athens, 96 in Gainesville. We're going to drop the temperatures just a little bit tomorrow, but unfortunately we're going to increase the humidity, which means now we're going to have to deal with some dangerous heat and humidity, the heat advisory. We'll talk more about that in detail a little bit later on. Now back to you, Carol.
John, thank you. An upstate Boy Scout leader is in jail after being accused of sex crimes against children. 47-year-old Milton Jeffrey Putnam of Anderson is charged with two counts of committing or attempting a lewd act on a child under 16 and one count of criminal sexual conduct first degree. With more, we go to News 4's Keisha Foster, live and local on the story from the Anderson Newsroom. Keisha, what led to Putnam's arrest?
Carol, investigators say one of the victims, a relative of Putnam's, came forward first. At this point, there are three female victims. Putnam turned himself in last night.
It's one of those things that once you get one, they say, well, I have a friend. And that's, all these girls know each other, they're acquaintances.
And that is how Lieutenant Steve Reeves says the Anderson County Sheriff's Office learned about Milton Jeffrey Putnam.
These three cases span a time frame back to 2008 here in Anderson County, with the most recent time frame up to May of this past year.
And according to the arrest warrants, two of the sexual encounters happened here at Putnam's home in Anderson. A third incident happened at a home in Belton. The victims involved were between the ages of 9 and 16.
One of the victims is related to the suspect in this case, that it was the victim coming forward to their parents and making a disclosure about something that happened. And that was almost like a domino effect from that point on.
By trade, Putnam is employed by a local company repairing and painting cars. Lieutenant Reeves says Putnam is also involved in the community as a Boy Scout troop leader.
None of the victims are boys. Okay. They're all girls.
Lieutenant Reeves says there could be more victims out there, and he encourages parents to talk to their children who may have interacted with Putnam. Now, Putnam also appeared in court today for an arraignment this morning. No bond was set. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson Newsroom.
Keisha, thank you. A Henderson County teacher is facing charges tonight. Investigators say she had sex with a male student. 38-year-old Leslie Messer was arrested last Thursday. Investigators say the encounter took place in June 2010 and that the young man was a student at North Henderson High School. School officials say Messer had been employed by the school system since 1999 and is a special education teacher.
Tonight, a man is in jail accused of killing two women in Simpsonville. 35-year-old Michael Crane is charged with two counts of murder. Police say they were called to do a welfare check at a home on Eastview Drive in the Poinsettia subdivision Tuesday. No one answered the door. Moments later, they went inside and found two bodies in the bedroom covered in bloody comforters. The Greenville County Chief Deputy Coroner identified the victims as 56-year-old Jane Lancer and 26-year-old Allison Cross. We're told the women died of blunt force trauma to the head and were likely killed early yesterday morning. Police say Crane dated Cross. He also lived at the home. Crane is currently being held at the Greenville County Detention Center without bond.
The Cherokee County coroner says a man burned while trying to steal copper has died. Deputies say 27-year-old John Van Spears was injured last month when he cut a 220-volt power line at a Blacksburg industrial site and it exploded. Spears was taken to the Augusta Burns Center and he died Monday night. Deputies say Spears was with two other men at the time of the accident. 23-year-old Donzel Martin and 18-year-old Leontay Jeter suffered minor burns. They were arrested. Greenville County deputies are trying to figure out how a woman landed in a construction zone along Interstate 385. There were reports that a woman fell or jumped from an overpass along Smith-Hines Road. The interstate was shut down at Butler Road, and the Greenville County Sheriff's Office was called in to investigate. We are told the woman was alert and conscious when she was found, then taken to the hospital. Deputies plan to question her about the incident. Meantime, if you saw what happened, call the Greenville County Sheriff's Office.
A repo company has a problem. Two cars they repossessed were stolen from their lot. Now they are on the hook for the cars. And as News 4's Sean Mozzarella explains, they're willing to pay for any information that gets their cars back.
It happened right in front of a security camera. This is from Monday night at 11:30 in front of State Recovery. It's a repo business off Kearns Avenue in Greenville County. At first, the man walks up, checks out the car, then leaves. But a few minutes later, he comes back, this time with something over his head. He finds the keys and drives off with the 03 Mercury Grand Marquis. Then about a half hour later, he comes back for the car parked next to it, a 95 Toyota Camry.
It was unbelievable that somebody would come and do that.
Rock Jose owns the repo company. His business will have to pay the clients if the cars are not returned. That's why he's willing to pay $1,000 for information leading to an arrest in this case.
We have to explain to our client, you know, why their car was stolen. And I believe one of the cars was actually the people were going to redeem it. And, you know, it's gone now.
But they're hoping it's not gone for much longer. Sean Mozzarella, WYFF News 4, Greenville County.
And a report was filed with the Greenville County Sheriff's Office. We're told they are investigating the incident.
Turning to Project Economy now, 100 new jobs are on the way to BMW, and company leaders say the opportunities won't stop there. The announcement came today in Spartanburg County. BMW says the new jobs will include engineering, information technology, and production management positions. The company also announced its new BMW Scholars Program. BMW will partner with Spartanburg Community College, Greenville Tech, and Tri-County Tech, so students can work there part-time while attending school full-time. The company says it will also invest $5 million for a new healthcare facility that will serve BMW associates and their families. General Electric is also hiring. The company held a job fair at McAllister Square in Greenville today. GE is looking for 120 CNC machinists to work at its Greenville facility. Now, these are hourly positions. By late morning, about 100 people had already shown up. There is still time to apply for one of the open jobs at GE, and we've posted a link on WYFF4.com. Just look in the Scene on 4 section. The NFL commissioner is in the upstate, and he is taking questions from football fans.
Roger Goodell is at the Panthers training camp right now, and that's where we find News 4's Angela Rodriguez with more. Angela.
Well, Nigel, he's signing autographs right now down here below us on the practice field. There, the big crowd of cameras is around him and team owner Jerry Richardson. But Goodell took questions from fans for about 30 minutes. The first thing he said when he picked up the mic, though, was he apologized. He apologized to fans for this trying off season. He thanked the fans for their patience and their support. He said the new CBA agreement protects the game, and he says it's going to be better for fans and for people who play the game. The only question from the crowd, though, that got an applause was about lowering the cost of ticket prices for preseason games.
I hear from fans consistently, and it's why we started to evaluate the potential of an 18-2 regular season. We know that the quality of the preseason is something we have to address. We talked about that a great deal in the collective bargaining, and we want to.
Politician there. Something we need to address. The short answer was maybe they'll lower preseason ticket prices, but it won't be this season. Maybe next year. But, of course, what Goodell was also quick to remind everyone about is that this new CBA agreement means that at the start of the season, every team in the NFL will have a chance to win the Super Bowl. And, of course, right now, if you're not at Panthers camp, we want to go ahead and show you what the big attraction is here right now. This is down on the practice field. See big number one down there? That's Cam Newton, the number one draft pick. Many fans here are here to see him take some snaps and see what it is he can do. And, of course, everyone here is excited for the new and upcoming Panther season. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Spartanburg.
We have breaking news.
And we do have breaking news right now out of GSP Airport. First and foremost, everyone is okay, we are told. But we are told an American Airlines flight blew two tires when it was trying to land at GSP. You could see the airplane there on the runway and fire crews out.
Yeah, the fire crews were brought to the scene just as a precaution, but we do understand that everyone on board is safe right now. The runway is closed. No word exactly yet when it will reopen, but of course, we will keep you up to date on this on WYFF News 4 and on WYFF4.com.
Yes, on a day this hot, a good vehicle with a good air conditioner would be perfect. But Spartanburg man says one vehicle he has with a cold AC stuck in the garage.
Not doing him any good there. Nope. He says his garage door opener is broken and the company that sold it to him will not fix it until next week. News 4's Tim Waller is looking out for you.
It's not that Curtis Williams of Spartanburg doesn't have any transportation, but he says this is not the time to be driving his old truck.
That truck, the air conditioning in that thing doesn't really keep me that cool. It works, barely works.
Williams says his good car with a cold AC is in his garage where it will stay.
And I heard a real funny type noise, like a
until the garage door opener can be repaired.
That you can't even pull this thing loose. See that? You can't put it loose. It won't come loose.
The trouble is, William says Sears informed him they can't send anyone to fix it until Monday, 5 days from now.
I just feel like I'm stuck. It seems like they should have some kind of system in case a person have an emergency, like what I have.
So we contacted Sears corporate headquarters in Chicago and explained to them William's dilemma. A spokesman promised to look into it further, especially after we mentioned the master protection agreement Williams paid extra for.
Paid good money for that warranty?
Paid him with my credit card.
Never expecting to be stuck with the truck. Tim Waller, WYFF News 4, Spartanburg.
Larry Costello, the head of Sears Public Relations, said he'll try to get the garage door opener repaired and quickly. We'll let you know how this turns out.
Now your live Super Doppler 4HD weather forecast.
And live Super Doppler 4HD showing things nice and quiet outside of the mountains. Different story in the mountainous areas and even in the foothills of North Carolina. So a batch of showers and even some heavy thundershowers earlier over you folks in Boone. They have since weakened as they continue to make their way off to the east and southeast. It's hot, plenty of sunshine in downtown Greenville right now, 99 degrees. Humidity, though, low at 24%. That's the reason we're not under any type of heat advisory. Southeast wind at 7 miles per hour. 99 also in Spartanburg with plenty of sunshine. Northwest wind very light. Humidity currently at 25%. And in Anderson, right now, it's 100 degrees, but at least have a little bit of a breeze. A west wind at 13 miles per hour, humidity very low at 23%, but it's going to go up, the humidity levels, as we go through the next couple of days. 91 right now in Asheville, west wind very light, light humidity at 36%. Severe thunderstorm watch for parts of Kentucky. Thunderstorms that earlier were up here in Kentucky and West Virginia have weakened considerably. No watches or warnings, just those weakening thundershowers moving through the northern mountains of North Carolina. 102 right now in Augusta, 99 in Macon, 100 in Chattanooga, 97 in Florence. It's 100 degrees right now in Greenwood and in Columbia, 91 degrees in Rutherfordton, 102 currently in Clemson. It's 102 also in Walhalla right now. These are high temperatures so far. The GSP International Airport, we reached 100 degrees this afternoon, breaking the all-time record of 98 degrees that's been around for a long time, since 1888. 92 was the high so far at the Asheville Airport. Missed the Royal Time record on this date by only 2 degrees. That was 94 degrees set back in 1957. So higher humidity levels tomorrow, so south of I-85. Heat advisory from 11 a.m. until 8 p.m. tomorrow evening. We have a system that's not very organized at all. This is Tropical Storm Emily. It will produce very heavy rains and possible dangerous and life-threatening mudslides for the mountainous areas of the Dominican Republic and Haiti as we go through the night tonight. And then it'll curve away from the southeast coastline of the United States. It could gradually intensify, and it'll produce some dangerous rip currents along the beaches of the Carolinas and Georgia this weekend, so be careful of that. 109 right now in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. 68 for the overnight low in the mountains tonight. A couple isolated showers or thunderstorms around the area. Partly cloudy skies. More humid tonight in the upstate. Overnight low in the middle 70s. Hot 97 in the upstate, but more humidity. So hot and humid. A slight chance of an afternoon or evening thunderstorm. A better chance on Friday going into the weekend. Temperatures drop with more clouds and then better chance of thunderstorms on Friday and Saturday.